Hi children, today we are going to start our politics chapter, third chapter, how the state government works. How the state government works. In this chapter, we will study about what is government and what are the organs of government and how the state government work. First, we are going to study about what is a government. Government is a body or a set of people. Government is a body or a set of people who have the power to make and enforce law within a country. So what is a government? Government is a body or a set of people who have the power to make and enforce law within a country. And government is the only institution in a country which can make laws and enforce them legally. Okay, so government is the only institution in a country which can make laws and enforce them legally. Now we are going to study which are the three organs of government. So already you learned in 6th standard, three organs of government are legislature, executive, judiciary. Legislature, executive, judiciary. Legislature, executive, judiciary. These are the three organs of government. Legislature, executive and judiciary. So legislature make law. Legislature make law. Executive enforce the law. Enforce the law. And judiciary will interpret the law. Whatever the law that is interpreted by whom? Judiciary. Judiciary will interpret the law. So these are the organs of government. Legislature make law and frame the public policies. Second one, executive. Executive enforce and administer the laws. Third one, judiciary. Judiciary has the power to interpret the law. Interpret the law means any dispute arise sometime within a society, many dispute arise. So such cases judiciary will solve all the dispute. So these are the three organs of government. Now we are going to study about what are the need for a government. So you know children, you are studying in school, so in your class a leader will be there. If there is no leader in your class, what will happen? There will be any discipline. You will fight each other. There won't be any discipline. Unwanted sound will come. So many problems will be there. In the same way, just imagine if there is no government, what will happen? There won't be any law for the country. There will be no law and no law and order, no rights and duties. That is the situation if there is no government, just if we are imagining. And we cannot live in peace. We cannot live in peace and we continue to fight each other with our neighbors, with our neighboring countries. We will continue to fight each other. This is called anarchy. So we won't have any harmony. We will fight with our neighbors. We will fight with our neighboring countries. This situation is known as anarchy. So what is anarchy? Anarchy is defined as the state of disorder. It is the state of disorder due to the absence of a controlling authority. If there is no any controlling authority, means what will happen? We will fight each other. So many problems will be there. Altogether there will be disorder. That is known as anarchy. So a government is very important to ensure peace, prosperity, commercial and economic well-being of all the citizen or of its citizen. Government is needed, and government is also needed for the protection of people in times of war. If some country is attacking us, that time who will protect us? If government is there, government will protect us. So government is very important for protecting the people from any types of war. Or government will protect individual liberty. Government will protect individual liberty, and government also will protect us from The attack of terrorist. The attack of terrorist. Finally, all together we can say that for maintaining law and order, for the protection of our rights, for peace, living in harmony, all these things we need government. So government is very important in a country. Next class we will study about state government, how the state government works. Next class we will study. I think today's topic is clear to you. If you have any doubt, ask me. We will meet in the next class.